My private jet has a bedroom with a king-sized bed, a screening room, and a full kitchen. But there are private jets out there that are, dare I say, even better than mine. Jets with two floors, multiple bedrooms, and enough extravagance to blow penthouses from New York to Monaco out of the water. And today, we're going to explore one that does just that. A custom-designed Boeing Business Jet 747-8i, which happens to be one of the largest private jets on Earth. The Boeing Business Jet 747-8i is a jet unlike any other. Sure, Boeing is known for making massive airplanes, but this takes it to the next level. The 747-8i is a special VIP configured plane that is primarily used by world leaders. Kuwait, Oman, Brunei, Morocco, and Turkey all have one for government use. The Crown Prince of Saudi Arabia, Mohammed bin Salman, also has one. That being said, you don't have to work in government to snag one of these, but you do have to have a lot of money. Take this specific Boeing 747-8i, which was custom made for a rich Saudi Arabian client. As I mentioned, it's been labeled the world's largest private jet, and My, that title isn't easy to come by. The 747-8i is a whopping 250 feet long, a little more than two-thirds the length of an American football field. In its standard commercial state, the plane can accommodate 400 passengers. But when you're adding in multiple luxurious bedrooms, bathrooms, and extravagant living areas, that cuts down the comfortable number of passengers to 30, and the max number to 50. While most journeys on a plane involve being scrunched up and having maybe 5 square feet to yourself, a flight on this plane offers 4,000 square feet of usable space, which is nearly 2 times the size of the average house. The plane's interior was designed by interior design firm Alberto Pinto, and the process took a little over 4 years to complete. While some private jet owners like to be ostentatious with their fortune by coating the interior in gold and gaudy furnishings, the owner of this jet went for a different approach, understated luxury. Upon entering the jet, you'll find yourself in a main foyer, a glossy room with a grand staircase that looks as though it belongs in a mansion or on a luxury cruise rather than an airplane. There's a decorative door with a neutral-toned patterned panel and a light feature that ties the whole room together. Upstairs, there are several seating areas and lounges, including a living room located inside the 747's iconic hump. I might sing its humps, its lovely plainy lumps. However, this part of the plane is actually reserved for children, so I'll refrain from belting out questionable 2000s music. That's right, this entire wing, excuse the pun, is reserved for children, including a play area and dining area. And if you've ever flown with children, you know what a blessing that must be. The children's living room has a bit of a mid-century modern flair to it, with neutral-toned wood, built-in bookcases, an embroidered suede ceiling, and a large sectional couch with an aisle's worth of pillows. Of course, there's a large television as well, where you can watch Lost or Sully, or perhaps Snakes on a Plane. Further towards the front of the plane, but on the lower level, you'll find the master bedroom directly below the cockpit. This may seem like an odd choice, but it is the quietest location on the plane. The master bedroom is immaculately designed, with a neutral geometric rug that ties into several other elements within the room. The ceiling has a recessed feature with angular lighting, and the lighting on the wall features a similar rectangular pattern as the rug. Whether you choose to sit on the love seat or the embossed leather queen-sized bed, light, temperature, and music controls are always within an arm's reach on touchscreen panels that are integrated into the walls and furniture. It's the perfect place to relax with a glass of wine, and if you hit turbulence, well, it's not a problem, because there are walled cup holders to keep your Sauvignon Blanc perfectly safe. Attached to the bedroom, you'll find the master bathroom, which features neutral colors and several gold accents, which look pretty fresh, as the kids say. There's a single vanity, plenty of storage, and the star of the show, the shower, which has a temperature dial and pressure dial for a spa-like experience. If you've never showered at 30,000 feet, you're really missing out. Of course, practically, it offers business people and world leaders a chance to clean up after long-haul flights and get put together for their next meeting. Luckily, your guests won't feel left out, because there are multiple bedrooms aboard the plane. The guest bedrooms feature a standard-sized bed and a desk, offering both privacy and style. In addition, each guest bedroom has its own in-suite bathroom, which may not have a shower, but is still miles ahead of standard airplane bathrooms. I mean, imagine the selfies you could take in that mirror. But once you're done freshening up and taking a nap, there are plenty of places on the plane where you and your guests can be entertained, including the main living area. Here, you'll find three couches arranged around glossy, quality furniture. The geometric pattern that is found throughout the rest of the plane is also prevalent here, pairing beautifully with the grid-patterned recessed ceiling above. Across from the seating area is a cabinet that looks like many others on the plane, but at the touch of a button becomes your very own TV stand. This keeps things from being cluttered while also offering the perfect spot to watch the game or catch up on the news. Beyond that TV is a table area, which really has the perfect setup for a game of high-stakes poker over a vintage bottle of whatever tickles your fancy. If you're not looking for privacy, it offers a space to have meetings. However, the conference room aboard the plane is much better suited for real business. That's right, move over, Air Force One, because this Boeing has its own conference room, which actually rivals some of the nicest ones I've been in. There's a TV built into a backlit bookcase, yet another Art Deco-inspired carpet, and lights that almost look as though they're a skylight. The chairs are made of fine leather and are adjustable at the touch of a button, so everyone can be comfortable during long meetings. There are also many more seating areas on the plane, including this interesting little section. It features a more traditional setup with leather armchairs reminiscent of usual private jets, but it has the added bonus of having built-in board games. The plane was, after all, built for a businessman to fly with his family, so I have a feeling they must certainly have a thing for board games, specifically chess and backgammon. When not in use, the games can flip over and snap into the table for a more professional look. Whether you're playing board games, napping, having meetings, or watching Game of Thrones on this plane, you can be confident that you'll get wherever you need to be with whatever you want because of the comfortable, well-equipped crew servicing your flight. The plane has state-of-the-art equipment in the cockpit, and there are large crew areas where flight attendants can rest up and prepare whatever your heart desires. And that's important, because this bad boy can take on some pretty long flights. The range of the jet is around 7,700 nautical miles, and for those who aren't pilots or sailors, that's quite a bit of distance. In a single flight, the plane can take you from New York to Hong Kong, or Los Angeles to Melbourne, or even Cape Town to Chicago. Just imagine going on a safari outside of Cape Town, then hopping on a jet to pick up some deep-dish pizza in the windy city for dinner. Well, when you're wealthy and have a plane like this, the luxurious possibilities are truly endless. So, there you have it, a tour of one of the world's largest private jets and one of the most impressive Boeing private jets the world has to offer. What do you think? Is this plane missing anything? If it were your very own private jet, what would you add to it? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to check out more fabulous private jets, be sure to check out my video here. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Oh, and turn on that bell icon, of course. As always, I'm Mr. Luxury. Now, if you don't mind me, I've got a flight to catch. Pip pip, da doodly doo.